What's up, guys? It's Arib Suez here, and I want to talk today about the news you probably heard about, that China has banned cryptocurrency. The sky is falling, and Bitcoin is going to zero. So China's banned it, and there will be no more Bitcoin, right? Well, not really the case here. Mining will continue, even if it were banned entirely in China. So that's not an issue at all. But let's take a look at what's happening in the markets and add some context. So if you look at the chart, as we can see, and as many of you probably know, it's the king of crypto. Bitcoin is like the index, and it's taken a huge hit. But it's your current correction was already in full swing before China banned all crypto and stole your lunch. So in mid-April, Bitcoin peaked at about 63K and could not hit the 65K or even 70K psychological targets, and then began a correction and a new downtrend at about 49K. On May 8th, Bitcoin tried to hit the 60K mark, but failed again and then began another correction, which is, of course, 11 days before China banned cryptocurrency and stole your computer. Bitcoin is even 45K a few days before the announcement from China. So is this a natural pullback or strong correction? Or did China now steal your car this time? But seriously, guys, looking at the timing, look at the chart here. You can clearly see Bitcoin was on the decline. It was already in a steep correction before that announcement. And so the other aspect that people have talked about is they said, "Hey, Arib, I thought China loved cryptocurrency just a few weeks ago in April. Brother Li Bull from the People's Bank of China spoke highly of it." Well, let's read and see what he said. We have to read between the lines, really, because Li Bull was very clear that he sees cryptocurrency as an investment and not currency. And he said it multiple times. So this is not really a surprise to me. This recent announcement just reaffirms and confirms what was stated by the People's Bank of China back in April. This also coincides with the successful trials of the digital yuan, which is considered a currency, obviously, within China, and is likely going to play a huge role in China's Belt and Road Initiative, right? The New Silk Road. So what's really going on? Is China really banning cryptocurrency? Or are they just telling us that it's an investment and it will never be a direct currency, in the People's Republic of China? I think that is what they're saying. That's not all bad news at all, though. And what I want to ask about now is, what do you guys think is the role that Tron is going to play? What role is Justin Sun going to play in all this? Well, I want to draw your attention to something that happened at the beginning of this year that didn't seem to get a lot of coverage. So we can see here that Justin Sun's Tron was rated the number two cryptocurrency by the MIIT. And so earlier this year, Justin Sun was invited as an editor on the NDRC, the National Development and Reform Commission, to consult on blockchain solutions. And we also know Justin Sun came to an understanding with regulators in China regarding the terms of the Tron ecosystem. So where is this heading? Well, first of all, we know that the digital yuan is not blockchain-based. We know China intends to keep the digital RMB as a dominant currency within China and for trade. So I believe the Tron ecosystem is going to play a huge role here. Whether it is TRX itself or just the JST, the Decentralized Finance Token and ecosystem, in order to exchange the digital yuan in and out. So I think Justin Sun's Tron is going to play a huge role here. Yes, China has clearly said that they don't see cryptocurrency as legitimate currency, but they said they see it as an investment. If it's an investment, I don't see why they wouldn't have something like the Tron ecosystem facilitate some kind of swapping in and out, which would be huge for cryptocurrency. So this is not bad news. This is not surprising news, what's happening in China, guys. I think we're in for a wild ride and a really exciting one at that. And China's going to ultimately provide a huge boost to cryptocurrency, and that we should keep hodling. Don't panic. The sky's not falling, guys. And correction, even large ones are expected given how much cryptocurrency has grown this year. So, guys, I just want to say thanks again for listening to my videos, watching my videos. Please like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.